गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वेलकम टू यूनिक टीचिंग मेथडोलॉजी। दिस इज एकता, योर होस्ट फॉर टुडेज सेशन। टुडे द वेदर इज क्वाइट कूल, बट द टॉपिक इज हॉट, HOT, हायर ऑर्डर थिंकिंग स्किल्स। बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट हायर ऑर्डर थिंकिंग स्किल, वी शुड नो वॉट इज LOT, लोअर ऑर्डर थिंकिंग स्किल। डिकोडिंग लेटर्स, साउंड्स, मेमोराइजिंग साइट वर्ड्स आर LOT. That is lower order thinking skills. And understanding what we are hearing or reading, it's higher order thinking skills. Higher order thinking skill is more engaging and intentional. It also help kids to improve cognitive ability. Let's learn more about higher order thinking skill from none other than Miss Harsha Ramaiah ji. Harsha Ramaiah ji is founder and director at Small Wonder Playhouse. She is National Core Committee Member at ECA, President at Team of Ignite Educators. She is Parent Coach at FirstCry.com. She is a speaker, she is a trainer, she is a storyteller. OMG, so many feathers in her hat.
Thank you.
So, Harsha ji, welcome to Unique Teaching Methodology.
Thank you so much, Ekta, for this warm, warm, warm welcome and appreciation. Thank you so much.
So Harsha ji, tell us about HOT, higher order thinking skills.
A wonderful topic chosen, Ekta, for talking. And generally, when we talk about HOT, very beautifully you introduced today HOT, that weather bahar bahut acha hai, but hot we are going to, you know. So HOT, I'm sure the educators are well acquainted with this word called HOT. That is higher order thinking skills. So there are a lot of other aspects attached to this segment. So today I'm going to talk about a few aspects which will definitely help all of us understand what does higher order thinking skills mean. So basically, higher order thinking skills is the understanding of any concept, understanding of anything that we read, we learn, or we come across. So it's basically a memorization. So when memorization is done without understanding, it automatically becomes rote learning. But when you understand the fact and you are then able to apply that fact, it becomes more effective. And that is what is related to higher order thinking skills. Basically, we all want our children, as educators, as parents, we want our children should not rote learn anything. They should understand a concept, because we all agree to this thing, ki if we understand, it stays with us for a longer time. But the curriculum that is offered in the school does not have that space. I'm very, very happy that NEP, which is coming across, has lot of place for this segment. So teachers will definitely have space to incorporate higher order thinking skills. Now, when I talk about higher order thinking skills, definitely these skills can be cultivated. These skills can be developed. These skills can be enhanced. It's not that you are naturally, you have these skills in you. You can practice and master these skills. So that is the best part of these skills. Second important thing is that HOT is not age related. That 3 saal ka bacha hai ya 30 years ka ek adult hai, so you know, you cannot develop HOT, that is higher order thinking skills, because it has nothing to do with age. It is definitely to do with practice. So as an educator, as a parent, if we try and understand, first of all, the understanding of higher order thinking skills is very, very important. Unless we understand, we won't be able to incorporate anywhere. So let's first decode and understand what does higher order thinking skills mean. Number one, as I mentioned, when a person memorizes and gives the information back without understanding, is rote learning. But when that information is given back with understanding, definitely it will have some added value. That is what is higher order thinking skills. So basically, I have prepared a few points so that I don't miss out on any important things, you know, because HOT is such a topic that it needs proper description. So if I miss out on any point, definitely the audience will lose out on understanding. So basically, when I talk about HOT, what is HOT? And how can we cultivate higher order thinking skills? So I will come up with an example also later in this presentation, but just let me give you a brief idea. Understanding of any fact, understanding of any knowledge, number one, is required to enhance your higher order thinking skills. So whenever we talk about anything that children are not understanding this, or we are not able to put this across in the classroom, number one point is understanding. So if we emphasize on understanding, and if we are able to take that time out to give that concept with understanding, only then we are just stepping on the staircase of higher order thinking skills. Many a times we have seen schools running with their course, running with their syllabus. There are too many concepts in one time that are introduced to a child. And then we expect that children don't think, children don't have innovative ideas, children don't have those creative imagination skills. Here I would like to underline that everything is time constrained. So in a school, if we are designing a syllabus, we have to be very cautious that are we jumbling too many concepts in one time, or are we allotting time for the understanding of that concept? If we introduce two concepts and we are expecting 100% understanding, I think that's wonderful. But if as a school I want to put up 15 concepts and it's just touch and go, and children are just mugging up and rote learning, that I'm sure children don't have any other option than rote learning. So what happens? For a little while, the children have those things on their mind, but as they grow in their age, things miss out from their brains. So as educators, as parents, it becomes very important for all of us to give or invest that time in understanding the facts to the children. So we have understood, but we have to allot that time. Second is conclusion of the topic or the fact or the information or the lesson or anything is very, very important. Because when the children understand, there has to be reason. So when I will share the example, definitely you will be able to understand that how both the things are interconnected. Once you understand anything, you start reasoning about it. So it's a process related to your higher order thinking skills. If I have not understood the difference between a vegetable and a fruit, I am sure I will never be able to classify which is the vegetable and which is the fruit. So I need to have proper understanding. I need to have proper understanding. Once I have that understanding, I will have my own reasonings. And with the help of these reasonings, I will be able to conclude. Then connect the other facts. So every information that we give to the children should be able to then connect. For example, if I have given the children some information that tomato is a fruit, for example, that is the information that I'm giving to the children, and I have given enough reasons for that information. Now, if the children have to use this information for analyzing that, for example, cucumber or apple or any other vegetable or fruit is a fruit or no, they will try to connect it. So this is another step of thinking. So number one is understanding. Second is reasoning. Third is making connections. So if I'm able to understand that tomato is a fruit, for an example, if I say, and I've explained to the children why, children will then reason it, try to connect those reasons with other fruits and vegetables to understand that why they are a fruit or why they are not a fruit. So this connection is very important. Then is categorization. So once you have topmost is the understanding. I will repeat this word again and again because it has to register in our minds. So number one is understanding the fact. Number second is reasoning. Number third is connecting. Once you start assembling all these things together, then you will be able to categorize that, okay, this is why tomato is a fruit. This is why apple is a fruit. This is why brinjal is a vegetable. So you are able to categorize with the help of the reasons that are given to you, with the help of the connections that are given to you. Then what we do in this higher order thinking skills, once we start developing these skills in children, definitely the children will put all the things together and then try sorting it out. So these are some steps when you do your lesson plans. So I also have an example over here. When I take you through this example, definitely you will be able to understand what I am trying to put across to you. So when these things come together, that is understanding, then comes the reasoning, then comes connecting, then comes categorization, then comes the manipulation. Because in understanding everything, it's not always 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Equations are not such everywhere. So in grammar also, we have seen that READ is read and READ is also read. So two pronunciations for the same spellings. So it's never 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 in thinking, in understanding. The depth of that knowledge manipulates. So that understanding has to be perfectly given to the children. So at times when they have to manipulate, for example, if I'm reading and I come across this spelling called READ, and in that sentence it is read as read, I understand, because now I can manipulate that this spelling is read over here, this spelling is read over here. So this is a simple example that I just want you all to understand that why I'm talking about manipulation. Because in grammar, there are a lot of such things that come across the children. So they have to understand the concept. And understanding will always be age appropriate and stage appropriate. So when you are introducing anything, say in LKG, it will have a level raised in UKG. Then again, a level higher in grade 1. Again, a level higher in grade 2. So that connection in teaching also has to be there. Otherwise, what will happen? Things will be midway. So that connection in your lesson plans also has to be there. Then apply what everything I have said. Understanding, reasoning, connecting, categorizing, manipulation, and bringing all the things together. Then let me give you an example, as I mentioned to you all. This will give a lot of clarity. So there are 6 levels basically in any higher order thinking skills that you want to develop in the children. So you will have to first have an understanding of this 6 areas of development. That is knowledge, comprehension, application, analyzation, creation and evaluation. Now, let me give you an example while I'm doing this. A beautiful story of Goldilocks. Hum sabne suni hai ye story. So now if I have to enhance higher order thinking skills in my children and I've taken up this story of Goldilocks, how will I apply that in my classroom? So for example, I have told the story, I have enacted the story, role play is done, everything is done. Now I am taking this story a little ahead because now my target, my aim, my goal is to make the children think. Our entire goal of education is not memorization, is not writing the information on paper and getting 10 on 10. Our duty is to make the children understand, think. Because if we are able to do these two things, only then we are able to produce adults who will be change makers. So we have to understand. So the story of Goldilocks, I have taught in the class. I have read the story, the role play is done. Now let's understand the application. For example, if I'm talking about knowledge, what I will do, I will ask the children to list down everything that Goldilocks used in this story, starting from where she started her journey to that bear's house and then further. So I will ask the children to list down. What will happen in this process is the children will think. I have narrated the story, I have done the role play, I have done everything. Now it's the time for children to wear their thinking caps. So a very easy task I'm going to give to the children is to list down. So here, I've experimented this with another story of monkey and the cap seller, and after finishing this, I will give you that example also. So this is number one thing. Second is comprehension. Let me explain why Goldilocks liked baby bear's chair so much. So that is the comprehension. You could pick up anything. I've picked up this. You could pick up anything to, you know, get the children's thinking on. So I've picked up. So let the children think, ki kyun usko wo chair achhi lagi hogi? Why the chair became her favorite chair? Let the children come up with answers. Let them come up. And when they come up, they could be weird answers. They could be totally imaginative answers. Let them come up. This is digging the creativity out of the children. This is making the children think. Then application. Next is application. Demonstrate what Goldilocks would use if she came to your house. So now what I have done, I have given that the ball of thinking now is in the children's court, you know. Now I'm asking the children, ki socho abhi Goldilocks aapke ghar pe aati to kya karti? And believe me, one sentence you have to tell in the class and they will come up with ideas. And this is opening doors and windows of imagination. See how much thinking takes place. And at times, you know, children not always come with weird ideas. They come up with practical ideas as well, you know. So this you will only experience when you do these experiments with children. So you tell the children that supposing if Goldilocks comes to Rahul's house, Rahul, what do you think she will do in your house? So then that time Rahul will start connecting the dots that in that bear's house, these many things were there. In my house, these many things are not there. Or in my house, things are different. So then they will start connecting the facts. See how much thinking, even when I'm talking right now, definitely so much of thinking is going in your mind as well. So think about a child's mind because that mind is so fresh with all the ideas. So dig out these things in the classroom. Then is analyzation. Compare this story to reality. What events could not really happen? So, you know, now you've talked about imagination, you've done everything. Now you have to bring them back, you know. So you tell them that इसमें कौन सी चीजें ऐसी है जो रियलिटी में हो नहीं सकती? लेट देम थिंक एंड लेट देम कम अप विथ आइडियाज, लेट देम कम अप विथ फैक्ट्स, विथ इंफॉर्मेशन. इट कुड बी दैट दे मे बी राइट, इट कुड बी दैट यू विल हैव टू इंटरफियर एंड करेक्ट देम, बट दे हैव वॉर्न देयर थिंकिंग कैप्स. आई थिंक व्हेन वी गिव अपॉर्चुनिटीज लाइक दीज, lot of higher order thinking skills definitely develop in children. Then is evaluation. So this entire process of Goldilocks and the bears ho gaya, now evaluation. Judge, ask the children that whatever the Goldilocks did, was it a good thing or was it a bad thing? You tell me, is it a good thing to without taking permission and going into someone's house and eating something? Is this a good habit, you think, for your own? Now, when I am asking the child to think, what happens? The child comes up with a conclusion. The child would tell me that, yes, it is not good, ma'am, to go to anyone's house without taking permission. It is not good to eat anyone's food without their permission. It's not good to sleep on anyone's bed. When the child is coming up with these things, these statements, means the child understands that these are wrong things. These are not good things. This thing will stay with the child all his life. You don't have to make the child rote learn what are good manners. You can do it just by telling a story and taking that story a level ahead. And it needs nothing. You need just a 20-30 minute period, extra period with your child. Instead of asking the children to write and copy the hard words, fill in the blanks and tick the questions and whatever exercises you do, drop that out. I would always insist to invest time in such discussions. And these discussions definitely will ignite HOT in children. And then next time when you deliver a story in the classroom, believe me, you will not have to take any kind of effort. Children will come up with ideas. Maybe the order of what I said, like knowledge, comprehension, would be idhar udhar. But my target is not to keep that order. My target is to ignite the HOT, higher order thinking skills in children, which I have already done. Next is creation. It's very important. And after this Goldilocks story, I will share with you the experience of monkey, Capseller and the monkey ka story. Propose how the story would have been different. So now take them to a different zone. You know, this story was of the Goldilocks and the bears. Now, if Goldilocks and the bear nahi hote aur bear ki jagah pe fish hoti, to kya hota? That much only. And I am now folding my hands and looking at the children. For example, it could be Goldilocks and the three fish. Bas, I am silent. Now see how much thinking. Fish hoti to ghar pani mein hota. Goldilocks would have to go in water, and Goldilocks ko swimming aati, nahi aati. So much of thinking. What have I done? I have just ignited the creativity of the child by changing the situation. So here in one storytelling, how many things, how much HOT I have ignited. Now, as I was talking about the monkey and the capsule story, what happened? We normally have storytelling sessions. Due to lockdown, now we are doing virtually storytelling sessions. So earlier it was that we used to call children at our school once a week, and then we used to do storytelling sessions. So I told the story of the monkey and the capsule to the students. And it was now the turn of the students to enact that story. And when I tell the children to enact, means they can put anything as creativity in that story. So this was a group of 7 to 8 children, all boys, and there was one girl. So they decided that we 7 will become the monkeys, and this girl, this I'm talking the age group is grade 1. So then this girl said that I will become the capsule. the first discussion that they had in themselves were amongst themselves was कैप्सलर तो मैन होता है ना, तुम तो गर्ल हो, तुम कैसे कैप्सलर बन सकती हो, तुम मत बनो कैप्सलर, क्योंकि वो स्टोरी में कैप्सलर तो ही वॉज अ मैन. सो आई वॉज जस्ट लिसनिंग टू दैट कॉन्वर्सेशन, सी थिंकिंग. नाउ जेंडर बायस थिंग इज अ सेपरेट इश्यू, बट दिस इज थिंकिंग एंड ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ वॉट देव हर्ड. नाउ इट वॉज माई टाइम एज अ टीचर टू इंटरवीन एंड से एंड टेल, ओके वो स्टोरी में मैन था, हमारी स्टोरी में तो गर्ल हो सकती है. एंड दे वर लाइक या यस. सो दैट इज अ टीचर्स जॉब टू इंटरवीन एट दैट करेक्ट टाइम. एंड सो देन दे स्टार्टेड, ओके दीज सेवन मंकीज, एंड आई सेड कुछ नया डालो स्टोरी के अंदर, हमने ये तो देख लिया, मैंने जो बोला वही आप सेम टू सेम करोगे तो मजा नहीं आएगा. आई गिव यू 5 to 10 minutes एंड यू ऑल थिंक, आप कुछ नया करो उसके अंदर. देन द चिल्ड्रन सेड मैम हम मंकीज का नाम दे. सो दैट वॉज अनादर थिंग That came to their mind and they started giving names. Now, another important thing is that while they were giving the names, the girl said, class mein se kisi child ka mat lena name, because then fir wo bacche hai na, usko tease karenge. See how much thinking of 6-year-old children they have. That they know that if a child is sitting here, if we take their name as the monkey, children would tease them. So see how much of discussion happens. Now again, it's the duty of the teachers to intervene and say, okay, to aisa karo, mera naam rakh do, Harsha, kisi ka monkey ka naam Harsha rakh do. To then Harsha monkey, ma'am monkey, maine kaha tease karna achhi aadat hoti hai. Is it good to tease? So what I taught the children, it's not only that story that I'm making the children. Children are learning so many things out of it. And beautifully they enacted. Kafi kuch discussion hua, but this is a few things that are still on my mind. And what process, and what I'm trying to tell you all is the process of higher order thinking, skills that I could put or develop or ignite in these children. So it's a beautiful concept. I will talk about Bloom's taxonomy also. It's little theoretical, but let me talk about Bloom's taxonomy. So he also has very beautifully highlighted a few points, you know, when we talk about higher order thinking skills. So I really like the way he's ordered each and every step, you know, when I talk about Bloom's taxonomy. It's remembering. Remembering is very important. See, there is a difference between remembering and rote learning. Anything that you understand and you have in your memory is what you remember. Anything that you don't understand, you just learn it without understanding, is rote learning. So we have to understand the difference between remembering and rote learning. So the first thing he said was remember. Then second thing again comes back to understanding. Once you remember, you understand. I really like this one ad flashing. Samajh aayega to, that some tagline of some Vedantu app, I don't know. Samajh aayega to maza aayega to samajh aayega. So beautiful, I think that is what, you know, is what HOT is. What HOT talks about, that once you understand, you enjoy. Obviously, subjects jo mujhe pasand nahi hai, kyun? Kyunki mujhe kabhi samajh mein hi nahi hai. So that's a very, very nice connection between understanding and enjoyment. If you understand, you enjoy, and you enjoy if you understand. So I really like that tagline. So it's understanding. Then comes the application of what I said in the classroom. I talked about storytelling. It could be any lesson, any subject. It's not that creativity can only be a part of English or language-based learning. Maths could be also wonderfully taught, putting creativity and enhancing HOT. Last week, I trained a few teachers of a school. I was taking the session of developing creativity. And that day, I told the teachers that, for you, what does creativity mean? Everyone came up with the idea that, the chart papers, the decorative bulletin boards, and everything if you are able to do. Matlab drawing, creativity is equal to drawing and craft. That day I gave an assignment to those teachers that today you will have to prepare a lesson plan and demonstrate here in front of me without using any chart paper or craft or drawing. Let me see how you all do. I very well remember there was a group of teachers who came up with shapes as their lesson plan. And there were 10 teachers, and beautifully each teacher demonstrated angles with the help of their hands. It was right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, parallel lines, everything just with their hands. And when I told the teachers ki aap blackboard pe ye draw karke padhate ho aur aaj aap aisa bachcho ko khade karke padhaoge, how long is this going to be with the child? The teacher said, yes, ye puri zindagi. If I am a part of being a rectangle or a right angle or whatever angles, if I am a part of that unit, I will remember it all my life. What a teacher is doing, taking little effort to think out of the box and igniting higher order thinking skills. The second group that came up was talking about the planets. And what they did, each teacher became one planet. They kept a chair in the center, portraying the sun. And each teacher became one planet. And the movement that was given, that Earth had, that Neptune had, that Mars had. So they started revolving around the sun in that position. So if you give children these kind of access, if you give children these kind of platform or opportunities, they will never, never, never forget concepts. They will never, never have any doubt. Agar bache ko earth maine aise sikhaya hai that there is a sun in the center and I am moving on my axis around the sun. And if my child is doing that in the classroom, the child will never have any question that how the earth revolves on its own axis. I will bring the globe and show it. That question still is in my mind because I don't have any clarity. So let's develop those lesson plans, and each and every subject can offer creativity. It's not related to language or storytelling because I'm sure that ye question aane wala tha ki ma'am stories ho to definitely creative ho, baki hamare maths ka lesson plan usme hum kuch HOT nahi kar sakte. So I gave you a maths example, I gave you example of social studies also. So then about analyzing, then once you remember, you understand, you apply, you start analyzing. And believe me, ek do baar aap ye practice karoge na class ke andar, children will come up with ideas. I have practiced this number of times. Then evaluation, I've talked about it earlier, and then comes creation. So this is all about HOT developing higher order thinking skills in children. There is a lot more that I can talk about it, but I'm waiting for the questions if we can pick up from the audience if you have any. This was from my side. Ekta, thank you so much.
Harsha, beautifully explained, and I could relate to this because I am also related to early childhood education, and we are also taking classes, online classes, how other schools are taking. And I always tell my teachers, always focus on whether kids are right, able to understand or not. Being in this field, early childhood education, true, we can be a change maker. If we start like that, then once they will go to higher standard, they'll start asking questions and teacher has to explain. So we have to start like that. And one question from the audience is, share some activities which parents can do at home.
Wonderful. Very so I will share my own example because I have a daughter of 7-year-old and she always keeps me crazy busy, you know. Supposing if you're sitting with your child and just watching television, let me tell you the simple activity. You're just watching a television. There's an ad flashing, any ad, Maggie ka ad ho, computer ka ad ho, kuch bhi ho. While seeing that ad, after the show is over, don't try to do between the show. So give enough time to the children. After the show, try talking about any ad that you were related to. For example, मेरे को कैडबरीज की ad बहुत अच्छी लगती है. That ad wherein, you know, there's a milkman, he comes every day to give milk and there's a child who's put the Cadbury in that bag, you know. So I start talking that Piyu, आज हमने जो वो ad देखा कैडबरी का तुमको याद है? I just have to tell that. I am not trying to ignite anything else. कौन सा वाला मम्मी? वो जो था ना वो दूध वाले भैया का एड, यू नो दैट मैन इज कमिंग टू पुट द मिल्क एंड देन वन डे दैट कैडबरी कम्स आउट. यस 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 मम्मा, हाँ, नाउ इज माय टाइम टू टॉक टू हर. बेटा अपने घर पे भी दूध वाला, आई हैव डन दिस सो आई एम टॉकिंग. सो बेटा अपने घर पे भी दूध वाला आता है, लेट्स यू नो डू समथिंग फॉर हिम. तो क्या करें? Then she said ki mama कैडबरी रखे. I said हाँ वो तो उसने किया था, वो ही रिपीट करना है. I don't mind if you want to do that also. She said, and she's very, you know, craft lover person. So she said, mama, a card bana do uske liye. So I said, yeah, okay. So she made to whatever, you know, best she could. She wrote the name. Bhagwan Bhai is that milkman's name. Bhagwan Bhai, thank you, Priyal and family. And she put it there outside. So these are simple things, you know, higher order thinking skills ke liye. You don't have to have fancy educational toys. You could pick up from anything and anywhere. If you are standing in a balcony and if you're seeing birds fly, ask questions. Bita, agar aapke paas pankh hote to aap kaise udte? Aapko kaisa lagta? Just that much. And children of young age have so many ideas, though they must not be realistic, but their minds are opening. So, बच्चों के साथ आप कभी भी, अगर आप किचन में भी हो, यू जस्ट फिलिंग अ बॉटल, जस्ट यू कैन स्टार्ट अ डिस्कशन ऑफ दैट कि बेटा ये बड़ी वाली बॉटल है जो मेरे पास, पापा को तो बड़ी बॉटल चाहिए, पीहू को कौन सी साइज की बॉटल चाहिए? देन शी विल कम अप विथ अ स्मॉल बॉटल. हाँ, पीहू छोटी है इसलिए पीहू के लिए छोटी बॉटल चाहिए. ओके, तो घर में कितने लोग हैं? वी आर फोर पीपल इन द फैमिली, सो वी नीड फोर बॉटल्स. So she said, हाँ मम्मा, फोर बॉटल्स. पर फोर बॉटल्स पूरा दिन नहीं चलेगा, वी विल हैव टू हैव मोर बॉटल्स बिकॉज वी ड्रिंक मोर वॉटर. सो सी हाउ मच वन थिंग इज कनेक्टेड टू द अदर. सो डेली लाइफ में बहुत प्रिपरेशन की जरूरत नहीं होती, यू कुड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम एनी वेयर. इट्स जस्ट द चैलेंज टू योर इमेजिनेशन.
Yes, and this ad na, ये काफी creative भी होते हैं. It's not always बकवास ad होते, लेकिन कई ads बहुत ज़्यादा
absolutely
it bring a smile on our face when we see. And I'll share one example the way you have shared, because I have done this, so I just want to share.
Yeah, please.
Is it okay, Sharad? Shall I share? Okay. One of my friend, my neighbor, she is having two kids. Very young kids, 3 years old and 4 years old. So मैं एक बार उनके घर पे गई थी, वो बच्चे बहुत परेशान कर रहे थे मम्मी को. You know lockdown, you know right how the kids are. So she was like very frustrated कि इनको तो कुछ भी बोलो ना तो इनको तो समझ में ही नहीं आता है. So मैंने उनको एक छोटी सी एक्टिविटी दी, मैंने उनको कहा ये टॉयज है ना, जितने सारे टॉयज है ना उसमें से मैंने उनको एक इंक्लाइन कर दिया एक सर्फेस को, और मैंने उनको कहा जस्ट चेक विच टॉय कैन स्लाइड, विच कैन रोल एंड विच कैन स्लाइड एंड रोल बोथ, और तीन सर्कल बना दिए. तो उसकी मम्मी आके, अच्छा ये तो ऐसा नहीं है. मैंने कहा यू डोंट सी एनीथिंग, लेट देम एक्सपीरियंस, लेट देम पुट इट. सो इतना ब्यूटीफुली वो एक घंटा बिजी हो गए उसमें, एंड दे वर लर्निंग आल्सो. सो वी हैव टू डू स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स व्हिच वी कैन एनहेंस देयर एचओटी. बल्कि उनको पता भी नहीं चलेगा ये लर्निंग है, उनको लगेगा ये गेम है. और हमारे स्पेशली हमारे इंडिया में मोस्टली पीपल आर बिहाइंड मगिंग ऑफ द थिंग्स, दैट इज द सैड पार्ट. सो आई होप दिस एनईपी विल ब्रिंग सम चेंज इन आवर एजुकेशन सिस्टम. And the way you explain about the story, मैं तो इसी में खो गई थी.
Believe me, all the storytelling sessions that we've done, children have really, मेरा story सुनना उतना उनको मजा नहीं आता है. But after the storytelling session that the children, you know, have freedom to do. Because majority what happens, you know, when children talk to us also as parents, you know, we are so much busy, अभी नहीं बेटा थोड़ी देर बाद. So they want to, you know, vent out. तो बच्चों को सुनना भी बहुत जरूरी है, कुछ भी वो लोग बोलते हो, but that ear has to be given to them.
इनफैक्ट आपने जो स्टोरी बताया ना वो स्टोरी को बाद में जो था ना उतना इंटरेस्टिंग था, बट यू कैन मेक एनीथिंग सो मच इंटरेस्टिंग वेयर इट्स विल बी इन्वॉल्व, नॉट ओनली लाइक वंस अपॉन अ टाइम एंड ऑल दैट. वी कैन डू मोर थिंग्स विद द स्टोरी, वी जस्ट लर्न टुडे. सो वन मोर क्वेश्चन वी गॉट, हाउ वी कैन आस्क किड्स टू डू रोल प्ले. द क्वेश्चन इज फॉर PP1 PP2.
ओके, सो दिस PP1 इज ग्रेड 1 एंड ग्रेड 2,
आई गेस.
और प्ले हाउस का पूछ रहे हैं.
आई थिंक वी विल टेक इट लाइक अ फर्स्ट ग्रेड एंड सेकंड ग्रेड.
ओके, सो आई विल आंसर बोथ वेज. इफ यंगर देन 5 इयर्स एंड 5 प्लस, सो यंगर देन 5 इयर्स यू विल हैव टू हैव अ मेजर रोल एज अ पार्टिसिपेंट. सो इफ यू हैव यंगर देन 5 इयर्स ओल्ड चिल्ड्रन, देन इट विल बी लाइक 80-20. Wherein they will have lot of observation of what you do, so you will have to be very active. If you have elder children, the part will be that you will have to explain them and take a back seat and allow them to release whatever they've understood. So you could take up any story, any character, any advertisement. I play with advertisement a lot because I really love. There is one ad jisme ek dada hai jo he's climbing the staircase with a patila and there are children coming down and they help that dada. So wo ad bhi maine apne school mein karwai thi. I play with these ads. Surf Excel ki bhi kafi ads aati hai jo positive message chhodti hai. So that could be role played. You, as I said earlier, as a parent or as an educator, will have to have those eyes open, what to take from where, because a lot of things are available outside. So, chote bache ho, to your role is going to be very active as a participant. Bade bache ho, to then you can tell them that, okay, this is the story and pick up the characters that you want. Pehle aapko story bata dena padega so that they can pick up the characters. Chote bache hain, to then you will have to tell the story. You will have to become one character or sometimes all the characters turn by turn. For example, rabbit and the lion ki story hai, to I am the rabbit, I am the lion, I am the other jungle animals. If my age group is less than 5, if the age group is 5 and above, definitely main story bol ke unko bol sakti hu ki y'all can become one character. Role playing is wonderful activity. Try and children will definitely enjoy that.
Okay. If you hear some story from Harsha, you can visit her page and see what wonderful work she is doing. I always go to her live whenever she'll be live.
Thank you.
See her live at 5, because this is Harsha always live at 5. So Harsha, you can just tell about your page name and so people can
sure. Sure. So I have my school page, that is Small Wonders. I also have a parent community Facebook group and page, that is Parent Station. So on that page and group, what we do, we have multiple activities for parents, for children, for everybody. So every day we have live shows. Main kuch shows leti hu. There are admins who take shows. Once a month we have games for the parents. So it's not always padhna, padhna, padhna. We have recreational activities as well. So just check out for that page, Parent Station and group Parent Station, and become a member. It's a wonderful community.
Yes, I agree. Yeah, I visit your page and enjoy your all the sessions.
Wonderful.
It's lovely talking to you, Harsha ji.
Thank you, Ekta. Thank you so much, dear.
Take care. Bye.
Bye, bye. Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh, I'm taking it and giving it to back to you. Thank you so much, Ekta. Thank you.
Thank you.